going to discuss about the unit number 5, that is engineering alloy steel and its designation. Myself, D.S. Dharekar, assistant professor in department of mechanical engineering, Chandigarh. Basic introduction about the alloy steel. Alloy steel. Initially we have to know that what is alloy. Alloy is the mixture of two and more metals, or combination of two and more metal, that is called as the alloy. In that unit we have to study the alloy steel. Alloy steel is a steel in which various elements other than carbon like nickel, manganese, tungsten, aluminium, copper, molybdenum, etc. are added to obtain the desired properties. Generally, these elements are added to increase mechanical, electrical, thermal, magnetic or resistance property. The main cause of adding alloying elements in a steel are as follow. First, to increase the hardness and wear resistance characteristics. Generally, we are taken the example of different type of tools. Tools are made from high carbon type of steel, but that high carbon only build the hardness, and we have to require the wear resistance characteristics. That times we are adding different alloying elements like tungsten, molybdenum, vanadium and chromium. It will be build the hardness as well as wear resistance characteristic. That is the main cause of alloying element. Then second cause, to increase the corrosion resistance. For example, stainless steel. Generally in the stainless steel we have to add more than 13% of chromium. That chromium is combined with the oxygen and forming the chromium oxides layer outside the surface, and due to that it will be prevent from the corrosions. Then third cause, to increase the resistance to abrasion and wears. If you have to making the diamond wheels, or we have to make the different types of grinding wheels, that time we have to see the abrasion and wear resistance characteristics. Then fourth cause, to increase ductility and machinability. And last one, to improve mechanical, electrical, thermal properties. Basic advantages of alloy steel. First, greater strength at elevated temperature. If you have to take the example of tool, if tool is continuously working at the different temperatures, that time if the tool is continuously running for the 24 hours, that time the temperature of that tool is so much higher. If we are not added the coolant on that tool, that times at the elevated temperatures, it is the one advantages of alloy steel. Second, high hardenability. Due to the addition of different alloying elements, metal get more and more hardenable. Then improve ductility and cracking strength. Then higher elastic ratio and endurance strength. Then better machinability at high hardness. And last, less internal stresses are generally built due to the addition of more alloying elements. Drawbacks of alloy steel. First drawback, higher cost than the plain carbon steel. Due to the more than one element is generally added in the alloy, due to that it will be built the more cost. Second, care should be taken during the handling. While we have to handle the two metals, that times we should take care during the handling. If both the metals are soluble in each other, or both the metals have affinity to each other, that should be known. Then third, tendency to have retained austenite. Some elements are generally forming the some retained austenite, that should be known. And last, certain grades show the temper brittleness. Effects of alloying elements. Solid solution strengthening and hardening. Alloying elements are the solubles in ferrites. They form solid solution with ferrites. Solid solution are the harder and stronger than pure metals, thereby increasing the strength and hardness of steel. Most of people know that what is the solid solution. Actually, solid solution is the type of alloy which is having similar crystal structure of base metals and alloying elements. That is called as the solid solution. If you have to see the one graph of alloying elements in alpha ions weight percentage versus hardness numbers in BHMs, we have to taken the different alloying elements: chromium, tungsten, vanadium, molybdenum, nickel, manganese, silicon, phosphorus. In that case, we have to see the 2% of chromium, it will be given up to the 120 mm BHN numbers. If you have to taken the phosphorus as the alloying element, less than 0.5%, it will be provide the 220 BHN number. That will be depends upon the type of alloying element generally added in the base metals, and that types of alloying elements generally what it will be forms. Either it is the ferrite stabilizer, or it will be build the some austenite stabilizer, or it will be forming the some carbides. That will be depends. Effects of alloying element. First effects, formation of carbides. Some alloying elements combine with carbons to form its carbides. The alloy carbides so forms increase the hardness and wear resistance. Whatever the alloying elements are generally added in the steel, some alloying elements are comes with the carbons and forming the carbides. That is called as the carbide former elements. For example, chromium, titanium, tungsten, molybdenum, vanadium. Chromium are combined with the carbon, they can forming the chromium carbide. Titanium are combined with the carbon, they can forming the titanium carbide. Tungsten are combined with the carbon, they can forming the tungsten carbide. That is called as the carbide former element. That is the first effect. Second effect, formation of inclusions or oxides. Usually deoxidizants are added to remove the dissolved free oxygen from the steel. If you have to manufacturing the steel, that time some oxygen get interrupted inside the steel. That oxygen are generally removed by addition of small amount of alloying element. That is the second effect of alloying element. The generally alloying elements are added to remove the oxygens is the aluminium, silicon, chromium, magnesium, etc. Generally aluminium are, if you have to added the aluminium in steel, they can forming the aluminium oxide. If you have to added the chromium in steel, they can forming the chromium oxide. If you have to added the silicon in steel, they can forming the silicon oxidize. That is the second effect of alloying element, formation of inclusion or oxides. Then third, formation of intermediate compound. Sometimes we have to added the some alloying elements in the base metal of steel, that they can forming the some intermediate compound with the iron. These compounds improve the wear resistance and other mechanical properties. For example, chromium, vanadium, nickel, silicon, etc. These are the some intermediate compounds formation elements. Then fourth, shifting, lowering of critical cooling rate. Initially we have to know that what is the critical cooling rate. Critical cooling rate is nothing but the, that means it is the minimum cooling rate required to form austenites to martensite. That is called as the critical cooling rates. Shifting, lowering of critical cooling rate. Different alloying elements have a different critical cooling temperatures. Ferrite stabilizer rise the eutectoid temperature, while austenite stabilizer lower the eutectoid temperatures A1. Okay, listen. Ferrite stabilizer, that means it will be increase the temperature of ferrite. That is called as the ferrite stabilizer. Molybdenum and titanium, if you have to added the molybdenum and titanium in the base metal of steel, it will be increase the temperature of ferrite 727 degrees Celsius to 910 degrees Celsius or above the 910 degrees Celsius. Due to that, it is called as the ferrite stabilizer. Then second one is the austenite stabilizer. Austenite stabilizer, it will be lowerize the austenite temperature. Austenites become stabilized above the 727 degrees Celsius or below the 1400 degrees Celsius. But if you have to added the magnesium and nickel in the base metal, it will be stabilized below the 727 degrees Celsius up to the 500 degrees Celsius. That means it will be shifting and lowering the critical cooling rates due to the addition of alloying elements. Then change in the volume during the transformations. The change in microstructures result change in volume of unit cell. alloy are added to reduce the volume impact. There are some alloying elements that will be put in the base metals. It will be change the volume at the time of formations of microstructures. For example, chromium, nickel, silicon, manganese, molybdenum, vanadium, chromium, nickel, phosphorus, and silicon. And other effects besides these, those mentioned above, alloying elements are added to improve the corrosion resistance and creep resistance. These are the basics effects of alloying elements. Properties and use of alloying elements. First elements, carbon. It increases hardness and strength. Second, it increases machinability. Second element, sulfur. It forms manganese, magnesium sulfides, which is hard and brittle. Magnesium sulfide promote chip formations and hence increase the machinability. And due to that, generally mild steels are generally, in the mild steel generally preferred the sulfur due to the it is having the good machinability. Then third element, phosphorus. It dissolves in ferrites. It increases the tensile strength and hardness. It is solid solution strengthened. It forms iron phosphate Fe3P, which is the hard and brittle and intermediate phase. It is also increase the machinability. Then next element, silicon. It is the ferrite solid solution strengthened. It improve the oxidization resistance. It reduce hysteresis losses. It increase toughness. Next alloying elements, manganese. It combine with the sulfur present in steel to form the magnesium sulfide and improve machinability. It dissolved in a ferrite and improve strength and toughness. It lowers ductility if present in a higher percentage. The next element, nickel. It is the ferrite solid solution strengthened. It dissolved in a ferrite. It increases the tensile strength and hardness. It increases corrosion and oxidation resistance. It is austenite stabilizer and lower critical temperatures. It reduces the coefficient of thermal expansion, and due to that generally it is used for making of measuring instruments. Then chromium. It form the chromium carbides, which is increase the hardenability. It increase the wear resistance. It increase the corrosion and oxidation resistance. Then titanium. It is the strong carbide formers. It prevent the localized precipitations of chromium carbides. Tungsten. It increase the hardenability. It form carbides and increase the wear resistance. It reduce the decarburization, burning of carbon, that is called as the decarburization. Next, molybdenum. It increase the hardenability. It make the grain refiner. It form the carbides and increase the wear resistance. It reduce the decarburization. Then vanadium. It promote the fine grain structures. It increase the hardenability. Its properties are similar to the tungsten and magnesium. And last one is the cobalt. It reduce the hardenability. It improve the strength. It promote the fine grain structure, and it improve the heat resistance.